looking at the line of cartoons I did before April, they're pretty much all recent comedic Western cartoons. Although Gumball and Foster's are amazing shows, they don't receive the spotlight that Avatar and Steven Universe claim. But everything is perspective, which is why even after I tear into a show for 35 minutes, I still put in my description that you should probably still support it if you like it. I don't do this because I'm a hypocrite. I do this because I am not a reviewer who will shame you for having a different opinion. So yes, you can hate Fanboy and Chum Chum. I'll be doing a major disservice if I told you that I hate Fanboy and Chum Chum and got on that bandwagon. If you have not seen my Fishhook review, then this review is going to be similar, although in this case, I am going to attempt to prove that Fanboy and Chum Chum isn't exactly what you think in this episode, present and not accounted for. This episode starts off with some pretty unsettling close-ups of our main characters. Chum Chum stayed up excited for Fanboy to wake up because it is Chum Chum's birthday. Now as a kid, once you realize the concept of what a birthday is, locations vary, you tend to want to celebrate it as early as possible. So this isn't out of the borders for a child.
Birthday song. I haven't heard that since the last time it was your birthday. Hey, oh, hey, it's your birthday! Hooray!
Not even a minute in and the conflict is already clearly stated. So Chum Chum subtly plays the you should know card, indirectly guilting Fanboy for forgetting.
Cause you never forget my birthday, and you always get me exactly what I want!
Also want to say that these jokes work in this episode. The main reason is because they do everything that Teen Titans Go and Modern Family Odd Parents doesn't do. They don't focus on one joke the entire episode. They have running gags for a short time. They switch up not only their style of comedy, but their jokes always keeping you on your feet. They do all of this while keeping the plot moving forward. Some of the comedy is very brute, and some people may label this as cheap. Honestly, I wouldn't blame you, because this style is often grouped with butt monkey jokes, such as torturing Meg or Kyle. The jokes work here because the person either A, deserves it, or B, ultimately doesn't matter in the direction of this episode. This one falls under B.
This is your fault! Why didn't you remind me?
I did! Every day! For a mom! Don't forget!
The episode will evolve around Fanboy eluding Chum Chum's party with the intention of getting a last-minute present.
Don't be upset if some of your classmates didn't remember your birthday. It doesn't make them bad people.
And then the exact opposite happens. Man, I miss saying that. The characters' personalities in this show can be described as interchangeable. Apart from Yo, Janitor Poopatine, and Kyle, the characters and the teacher don't really act one way. I wouldn't necessarily say that their change is how the plot needs them to be, but rather their core personality is there. But their reactions aren't always set in stone. So, a selection of the classmates decide to tell Fanboy about their present. Each of them giving Chum Chum an amazing birthday present. Now, since Fanboy and Chum Chum overly exaggerate everything, it is only logical for their presents to be just as over the top. One can argue that their presents don't always reflect their opinion of Chum Chum and in select episodes, but you see, the presents are just a symbol for Fanboy to feel more and more guilty. As you saw in my open-ended video where I said cartoons must make sense, this makes sense because the point of this is to make Fanboy more guilty. The present is largely irrelevant. They each assume that Fanboy is going to outtop all of them and thus are just as happy to give Chum Chum the best he deserves.
You always get me exactly what I want. Exactly what I want. Exactly what I want. And also, we're out of toilet paper.
This is what separates the episode from a guilt trip and a careless mistake. Chum Chum doesn't hammer in the point that Fanboy is going to get him the greatest present in the world. Everyone only says it once. They treat this just as a birthday. And Fanboy has all of this going on in his head.
That should buy me enough time to find Chum Chum a... manner of speaking.
This joke slightly went over my head. See how this joke isn't the same as the clock? They don't just repackage the same joke over and over. Now it is time for Kyle's segment. Although it isn't the best part of the episode and it could be padding, it isn't terrible and is actually pretty good.
So dark. It will cause you mere mortals to weep before me and bow down in awe of my infinite power.
a bit cheesy, especially because they did the multiple arms gag later in the episode, but it gets the job done. So Fanboy gathers flowers from behind the school for his last minute present, but gets outshined again by Manartica.
I don't normally do private birthday parties, but I got this very touching letter from one Cristobal Chuggy. It reads, "Wah wah, wah 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 wah," and this is the part that really breaks me up. Wah.
See how this joke isn't like the clock joke or the donkey joke? It's different. They throw all of these jokes because you're bound to think at least one of them is funny.
We can't open presents before we have cake and ice cream. And I don't see any ice cream, so we can't open presents. Oh well, boo-doo, birthday's over. Sorry everyone, time to go home.
Fanboy gets more and more desperate as his options get limited. Then Janitor Poopatine gives him an offer. For money, he will resell confiscated toys. To the untrained eye, this may seem like a detour from the plot, but this is a running joke from the series. The Toy Police is a minor but recurring character in the series as well.
Please, Toy Police!
Oh, please, the fuzz!
This works because it has continuity in the episode. Also, the Toy Police confiscates the briefcase after Fanboy chose it as his last minute gift. This also makes sense because it actually came from the crime scene.
I'm afraid I have to confiscate that briefcase.
No!
I'm sorry, Fanboy, but this is evidence.
Honestly, I think they could have handled the scene better. The cry talk is slightly annoying. He confesses that he just forgot Chum Chum's birthday, therefore he didn't really get a present for him.
Being together is the best present you could ever give me. And that's exactly what I want.
This part is pure cheese, pure safe answer. Ugh, it's just so cheesy and so safe. They didn't try anything new. But it gets the job done. It shows that not every episode ends in random crap that doesn't make no sense. It does make sense. In this world, everything comes together nicely in an ending that may or may not have been predictable. Why this works is because this episode shows the lengths Fanboy is willing to go through just to make Chum Chum happy, and to show how much he cares for him. It uses different types of humor. It's sugar high and random, but with a sense of grounding. All of these come together for a great episode. So when someone says that Fanboy and Chum Chum is a bad series, remember every series has their duds, and this is definitely not one of them. So this is the last episode before the 25th episode, which is going to be really big, and I'm working on it while you're probably listening to this, or maybe it's already done. Most likely it's already done, but you know it's not done at the time of me recording this? Requests. So if you have a request, let me know in the comments below. I am taking requests until mid-June, and I'm also going to take this time to work on some of the backlogs of Animation April, as well as other cartoons that I'm going to be doing, as well as any other requests that I have. And as always, I hope your time is well spent, and Alpha out.